I made a video on Bitcoin mining in 15 lines of Python code, and I received many questions, same questions, such as what do you do after you get a new hash, or how do you exactly redeem your reward? So in this video, I'm going to tell you how Bitcoin miners redeem their reward and transfer those Bitcoins to their digital wallet. Now, this particular video is a prerequisite, so make sure you watch Bitcoin mining in 15 lines of Python code first, and then you jump on to this video. Also, if you don't know what is Bitcoin, then you can in YouTube type in what is Bitcoin code basics, and you'll find this particular video where I have explained Bitcoin using a simple analogy. So you watch that, and now let's start this particular topic. So in real life, there are transactions happening in Bitcoin. Bitcoin is like a currency. So let's say Rob goes to a coffee store and he will buy coffee for this particular amount. And then let's say it's my brother's birthday. I give him 5 Bitcoin as a birthday gift, and Jim bought 2 Bitcoin from Coinbase. So there are people throughout the world making all these transactions in Bitcoin. And these transactions go to an area called transaction buffer or a mempool. And these are unconfirmed transactions, which means these are not added to your blockchain yet. And the job of Bitcoin miners is to produce valid blocks. So there are popular Bitcoin miners such as F2Pool, AntPool, Slush, and so on. And they will be looking at this transaction buffer or listening to this transaction buffer, get the block of transactions, you know, like 2 megabyte, or there is a block limit. So they get certain amount of transaction and they start mining it. You know, they start producing that hash, which I discussed in my previous video. And let's say F2Pool is the first one who can come up with the valid block. It's possible that other miners might come up with the valid block, but this is a game of who gets lucky as well as who is fast, you know. So it's a combination of those two factors. But in this scenario, let's say F2Pool comes up with the valid hash, and that hash gets added to our official blockchain. Now let's go a little into detail on how this particular block is mined. This is what I covered in my last video. But basically, let's say if I'm F2Pool, I will collect all these transactions from the transaction buffer. So this particular block is transactions, and it will have a previous hash as well. Now this is the first block, so previous hash is 0, but usually you already have a block, so you get a previous hash, and then you produce the SHA-256 or a hash for the entire block in this green particular rectangle. So whatever content you see in this great green rectangle, we make a hash out of it, and let's say hash is 0.45, whatever. Now if you notice the transactions carefully, very important is this yellow transaction. So at the end of the transactions, at the end of the block, the miner will add a transaction to himself or herself saying that reward me 6.25 Bitcoin. So as of 2021 April, the reward for mining one block is 6.25 Bitcoin. So the miner will add a transaction to himself or herself in that block itself. So it's not like you're mining and then later on someone transfers you the money. As part of the mining process itself, you add a reward to yourself in that block. And then whatever you see in this green box, you produce hash out of that. So now you all know that, you know, it's a guessing game. So you have nonce is equal to 1, then you put nonce is equal to 2. You keep on trying this. It's a trial and error. You keep on trying this nonce, and eventually, let's say for some nonce, you know, this is not nonce 3, but let's say for some 20,000 or 1 trillion nonce, you get first 4 zeros. I'm just giving hypothetical example that if my protocol says that a valid hash is the hash which has 4 leading zeros, then once I get to this hash, it means I have produced a legitimate block which I can add to the blockchain. So once I get this, I will broadcast in my network saying that, hey, I have produced a valid block, and the other peers will add this to the blockchain. It becomes part of the blockchain, And when it becomes part of the blockchain, you already have a reward. So to answer that question, how do you redeem the reward? Well, while you are mining the block, you have added that transaction, that reward in that block itself. So all you need to do now is wait till the block gets added to the official blockchain. And once it is in official blockchain, you have already won that reward. So the actual blockchain looks like this, where the last transactions in every block is the reward actually. Okay, so here let's say this block was mined by F2Pool, the other block was mined by a miner called Slush, third block was mined by, let's say, Antpool. So if you look at the whole blockchain, you, in every block you will see a transaction, a reward going to a miner. Now I'm going to show you a real block. So if you go to blockchain.com and click on Explorer, you will see all the blocks which are being mined. So let me look at this particular block. You know, this block was mined by F2Pool 44 minutes ago. And when I open this block, what I see is general block information. So right now the difficulty, since my presentation, I said the difficulty is first four zeros. You see first four zeros, right? In reality, the difficulty is first 20 zeros. So if you count this, this is 20 zeros. So F2Pool was able to successfully mine this particular block with 20 leading zeros, okay? And you will see all, let's say this particular block had 100, 1,091 transactions, and the block reward was 6.25, and the fee reward. So there are, you know, transaction fees as well. So in this one, he got block reward of 625 and the transaction fees is 0.911, whatever, right? So if you just sum these two numbers, so let me just sum these two numbers. So you will see 7.161 going to F2Pool. So this is F2Pool's digital wallet, the public key. So this reward went to F2Pool, and you know, it's like from and to. So in the from, it says Coinbase newly generated coins. You see newly generated coins. And then there are rest of the transactions. So the hash, this particular hash was produced including the reward transaction. So now you get the point. And you look at other transactions, see so many other transactions, like 10 pages, all right. In other transaction, let's say this transaction, this particular address, okay, this particular address transferred 12.42 Bitcoin to, you know, all these addresses. So it's like from one to many, the destination is like many, many digital wallet addresses. So the source address here, you can see the source address, total receive, total send, some transaction history and so on. But this particular transaction is, you know, it's a special transaction. It is the transaction which I showed you here in yellow. It is how Bitcoin miners get a reward. So I hope that clarifies your understanding on how exactly miners get the money in their wallet. And if you have any further question, post in a comment below. I'm going to make a playlist. So the playlist link is in a video description below. So go check it out. I will be posting many more videos on Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies. Thank you very much for watching.